Kate Middleton's ring from Prince William shows she is already preparing to be queen. Kate Middleton, 38, and Prince William, 37, have been married since 2011. Before this, they dated for many years, and a gift from Prince William could have shown Kate was already preparing to be queen early on in the relationship. Kate Middleton and Prince William met at university in 2001 and began dating soon after. Although they did not get married for 10 years, a ring given to the Duchess of Cambridge early in their relationship could have shown she was preparing to be queen. Kate and Prince William met when they were both studying at the University of St. Andrews in 2001. Apart from a brief separation in 2007, the couple dated from 2003 until their engagement was announced in November 2010. Prince William is second in line to the British throne, which means it is likely Kate will one day be queen consort. The couple may have met 10 years before they tied the knot, but they may have had talks about Kate's important royal role much earlier on. Early into their relationship, William gifted Kate with a beautiful rose gold ring with a hidden meaning. Eddie Levian, CEO of family-owned jewelers Levian, told Express.co.uk. He explained, "This beautiful, delicate ring is understated in style, but the very personal message hidden within it from a future king makes it an enormously romantic royal jewel." William gifted Kate this Victorian rose gold band encrusted with pearls and garnets, while they were still at St. Andrews University, where they met as students. Although the Duchess of Cambridge rarely wears the piece, she showed her commitment to her new royal life by wearing it at her graduation in 2005. "It's no surprise Kate was seen wearing it at her graduation," Eddie continued. "This was a milestone marking her own achievements, but also a day which put her on the threshold of a new chapter in her life together with William beyond university." By dating Prince William, it is likely Kate knew how her responsibilities in the royal family could grow. The understated ring was personal to the couple, as it featured both of their birthstones. Wearing this showed Prince William's commitment to his future wife early on in their relationship. Eddie explained, "The ring is adorned with both Kate and William's birthstones, in a celebration of their bond and the beginning of their intertwined destiny. Pearls are a June birthstone, William was born in June, and they symbolize love, purity, humility and innocence. Garnets are the birthstone for January, when Kate was born, and were named by the ancient Greeks for their color resembling pomegranate seeds. Garnets signify protection and are thought to promote confidence and mental clarity." Even though Kate graduated in 2005, and the couple married much later in 2011, this ring goes to prove that William was smitten with Kate even in those early days. Since then, Kate has showcased many pieces of stunning jewelry she has received as gifts from her husband. Kate and William could change royal duties forever after lockdown opens new opportunities. Kate, the Duchess of Cambridge, and Prince William revealed they prefer video calls to face-to-face meetings to carry out their royal duties, hinting the royals could change how they work in future. The Duke and Duchess Cambridge found working online removes the faff of royal protocol and allows them to enjoy in-depth conversations one-on-one. The couple made the shock revelation to BBC's Tina Daly. Ms. Daly said, "You don't have to faff about with all the other stuff and only having a set amount of time and having to go somewhere and meet loads of people. They like that you can have an in-depth one-on-one conversation with people." She added, "They much prefer it. I'm not saying they don't want to meet people face-to-face, but they've really enjoyed speaking to people on video calls and using Zoom." The BBC journalist said she'd been surprised by how normal the couple are, who wanted to know her thoughts on how the coronavirus might impact society and the things people value. The Duke, 37, and Duchess, 38, delighted fans with a rare appearance on BBC's Big Night and to show their appreciation for NHS frontline workers last Thursday. Prince William was filmed talking to Stephen Fry, in which he mocked the royal for his poor use of technology, before the whole family joined the clap for the NHS from their doorstep. Speaking about the clip, royal commentator Richard Fitzwilliams told Express.co.uk, "Last night's superlative skit involving Prince William and Stephen Fry deserves a BAFTA nomination. There have been a series of famous occasions when the royals have promoted events in ingeniously unorthodox ways. The royal couple are self-isolating with their children at Anmer Hall, their country home, in Norfolk. Since lockdown, the pair have revealed how they homeschool their children. Gates admitted it had been challenging teaching their three children, George, 6, Charlotte, 4, and Louis, 2, despite their stamina. She said, "Don't tell the children, we've actually kept it going through the holidays. I feel very mean. The children have got such stamina, I don't know how. Honestly, you get to the end of the day and you write down the list of all the things that you've done in the day." They have kept homeschooling going through the Easter break to maintain some structure. Kate added, "It's just having that bit of structure actually. And it's great, there's so many great tips online and fun activities that you can do with the children, so it hasn't been all hardcore." Meghan Markle will never wear Queen's jewelry now after stepping down from royal role. Meghan Markle, 38, married Prince Harry in May 2018. As a wife of a British prince, the former actress was lucky to benefit from a whole host of incredible privileges. This includes a wedding worth millions of pounds, a huge property to call home in Windsor, renovated to the tune of £2.4 million. However, the Duchess never had access to the Queen's jewelry collection, and now it is likely she never will have. Royal jewelry plays an important role in protocol, although few would know it. While most see tiaras as simply pretty headpieces, there are rules about who gets to wear one, and when. For example, only married women are traditionally allowed to wear tiaras. When it comes to the British royal family, there is one woman who makes the rules, the Queen. Express.co.uk sat down with James Constantinou, founder of Prestige Pawnbrokers of Channel 4's Posh Pawn. He said, "Meghan Markle is known for wearing jewelry with strong messages and meaning. The Duchess has often worn jewelry with hidden messages, including revealing the birth month of Prince Archie early on in the pregnancy by wearing a ring with his birthstone. She also gave an early indicator of her relationship with Harry, when there were just rumors, by wearing a necklace with an H initial." James added, "Meghan wore the platinum Queen Mary diamond bandeau tiara on her wedding day and has worn several pieces of Princess Diana's jewelry. Meghan's engagement ring has two diamonds once owned by the late princess which now form part of Meghan's engagement ring. If the occasion is right, Meghan may opt to wear something from the royal collection again with the Queen's approval." However, will Meghan ever get the Queen's approval? It seems highly unlikely, given previous precedents set by Her Majesty. The Queen has never lent Meghan jewelry, besides on her wedding day, and has never loaned jewelry to anyone who is not a senior member of the royal family. Why didn't Meghan Markle wear the Queen's jewelry? It is not true that Meghan has never worn a piece of the Queen's jewelry. On her wedding day, Meghan wore the Queen Mary's bandeau tiara, which belonged to the Queen's grandmother. However, this was the first and last time Meghan ever wore a piece belonging to the Queen. It is claimed Meghan hoped to wear an emerald tiara with Russian connections, but was told no by the Queen, causing some tension within the family. The royal family has never released any information detailing why Meghan did not wear the Queen's jewelry, but Meghan is not the only royal bride to have never worn a piece of jewelry from the Queen's collection. Sarah Ferguson similarly did not appear to ever borrow a piece from the Queen's archives. However, she was given a specially commissioned tiara, necklace, earrings and bracelet set from the Queen on her wedding day to Prince Andrew. However, Princess Diana, Camilla, Duchess of Cornwall, and Kate Middleton notably have. There could be some speculation, therefore, that the Queen favors wives of those in the direct line of succession. However, Sophie, Countess of Wessex, has also worn the Queen's jewelry, disproving this theory. Royal women tend to wear tiaras for important diplomatic events. This includes diplomatic receptions and state banquets, in the UK and overseas. Kate often wears the Cambridge Lover's Knot tiara to such events, though she has also worn the Queen Mother's Lotus tiara in the past. However, despite attending state banquets on royal tours abroad, such as in Fiji, Meghan has never worn a tiara at one. It was claimed by a source Prince Charles was left to tell Meghan she was not able to wear a tiara to the event in October 2018. This was to avoid looking too extravagant in parts of the Commonwealth, it is claimed he told the Duchess. A source told Mail Online, Meghan did not understand all of this because she was new to the role, and so Prince Charles told her that it would not be appropriate. It was very kindly done. Meghan did not attend her one opportunity to wear a royal tiara at the UK state dinner to welcome Donald Trump to the UK in June 2019, and neither Meghan nor Harry nor the royal family released a statement detailing why the Duchess of Sussex was not there. A Sun exclusive claimed Meghan was banned from wearing royal jewellery by the Queen, especially gems worn by Princess Diana, at the behest of Prince William. A source told the publication, "This is a surprising situation that has been going on behind the scenes over the past few months and has caused tension and upset, especially for Harry. It is at the discretion of the Queen and trusted advisers which items in the royal collection she chooses to loan out and to whom." Aspects of Meghan's behavior, including before the royal wedding, caused resentment with forces within Buckingham Palace. While the royal family are yet to confirm these reports, however, at the time senior royal sources insisted that Meghan is in fact allowed to wear pieces from the collection. Despite this, the Duchess of Sussex never did. The closest Meghan came to wearing a piece of jewellery from the royal collection was when she went out for her first official engagement with the Queen in Cheshire. Meghan wore a pair of pearl and diamond studs, at first thought to belong to the Queen by fans. That was until it was noticed that the Queen was in fact wearing her versions of the piece. It was confirmed by Kensington Palace that Meghan was wearing replica pieces, bought for her by the Queen. However, Kate has worn the Queen's own pair of the earrings, begging the question, why did the Queen go to the trouble to make Meghan her own pair? However, this is not to say Meghan doesn't enjoy a lavish jewelry collection, some of which has been bought for her by members of the royal family. Most glaringly obvious of these is her ring from Prince Harry, which was estimated to have cost just over £150,000. Her aforementioned pearl and diamond earrings from the Queen cost an impressive £4,275. Other items that Meghan has worn includes Princess Diana's £75,000 aquamarine ring, which Meghan wore on her wedding day. She also has £60,000 Cartier drop earrings.